All right, well, we're back again, and today is Saturday, July 3rd, and this is Matt Wright, and
I'm Jeremy Elliott,
and once again, here we are. We told you we'd be doing videos every single day, and we're keeping our side of the promise up. Now, it's up to you guys, too, please to keep your side up. Write us questions, watch the videos, tell people about them. We really appreciate it, and they appreciate it. Maybe they learn something good that can help people, can help themselves.
Getting the word out is important, for us, at this point in time, too, just because it's hard to, financially and things like that, it's hard to, distribute things all over the world or whatever, but we're just doing the best we can,
No, I don't need any money. Money will come when it's meant to be.
Yeah, but money is not the important thing. We need more word of mouth. More.
Word of mouth, yeah. Let people know. If you like what you see here, let people know.
Absolutely. It will help.
All right, well.
Help us to help you.
Yeah. That's a good way of putting it.
Yeah.
Well, last night on that seventh video, the wrap-up video for Friday, each night, I think we tend to do the last video, I call it like a wrap-up video or this open discussion or something like that.
Right.
And we started talking about aliens and other planets and
alien race,
alien races that are out there in the universe that we've seen before in spiritual meditations and,
well, one thing
and
I
other side and other things like that.
One thing I wanted to say is that, I guess you're only an alien depending on where you're looking from,
It's your perspective.
Yeah, because we could be the aliens, alien's kind of the word, it means that it's, somebody that's not from here or from wherever you're at. Maybe from a different planet, we'd be the aliens.
That's right.
Throw that in.
And we are aliens.
Yeah, we are aliens.
We're aliens to other aliens. The aliens were aliens.
Yeah.
Think of it like that, because it's the truth.
That's right.
There's a lot to say. I mean, this is a big subject, and the first thing we've got to clear up is that they are aliens. I guess you could tell by our tone of voice. We'll keep it simple. We'll start out simple for people who are beginning this.
There are
alien, thousands of different types and races. Most of them are way more intelligent and learned than us, And they're out there, but they can do what they want.
They definitely keep themselves under wraps most of the time, and it's probably a
good thing.
Yeah, it's a good thing,
at this moment, at least.
Yeah, because people will go crazy, get upset, and, it's hard to deal with, knowing this kind of thing sometimes. But it is important to know that, we are not alone. And probably anybody that's been in outer space especially would tell you for sure.
Yeah.
We're not alone, That would be a ridiculous comment to make almost, from someone.
Remember we talked to that astronaut, I mean to cut you off, but remember we talked to that astronaut who died in the 80s?
Yes.
And then she was showing me, the secrecy agreement in my mind. Mm-hmm. She was showing me that she signed about not disclosing UFOs and all this stuff.
Absolutely, I remember that.
I remember she was talking about that.
Yeah, NASA
knows about that. They don't want no one to say anything.
Yeah, we know they don't want to say anything about it. It's a big secret. We know because we talked to Spirit about it. And two, it's just commonly known that we don't want to, aliens don't want to be known or it's apparently either a secret or a fraud, but it's not a fraud, it's just a secret.
It's a secret, and it's usually, aliens, there's so many different races of them operating here, but,
I've had a lot of interesting concepts about how long aliens have been around, it could just, it could go forever and ever, probably, as far back, as life has existed,
Oh, yeah, God goes back billions of years, trillions, In fact, Jeremy and I, which we've mentioned in other videos, we've gone through a lot of our past lives, and we've been aliens.
Oh, yeah.
We've lived as extraterrestrials or in the past, We've had alien lives, lots of them,
Floated in spaceships, seen other galaxies,
I was like, one of my lives, I was a captain of some kind of time ship or thing, a dimensional ship. You know, the thing like, you know, Jeremy and I can both see it with our minds. It's probably like 3 miles long.
Yeah, I tried to draw it one time, but I'm not the world's greatest drawer or anything, but I tried to.
Because you did it like, it was like 20 football fields long or more. Yeah. You know, that's just the length. It's like, but
it's huge. I mean, the ships, apparently, you know, there's the ships out there, but they use cloaking mechanisms and things like that to hide themselves.
That was millions of years ago
when
I was doing that. Yeah. That was millions of years ago.
And what do you think about that?
I was doing that.
And, like, what do you, the audience, think about when you think of millions of years ago? You know, you probably think of, what, dinosaurs and things. Well, there are still aliens flying around doing their thing, you know.
Like, I'm seeing something right now. Like, I think I'm opening up to some past lives and stuff. You know, like, I think I see a woman, but this is a real colorful dimension or world. You see that, like, she's got some kind of gown on in white with tinted, looks like it's shimmering with colors.
I can see her now, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It clears day. It's real clear.
She's just kind of like, with her mouth hanging open, her eyes are kind of big.
I think this was you. You know, like, I'm feeling this might have been you or me. Like, this is the world we lived on. This is what I'm being shown. You know? Like, let me see. Who was the woman? Let me see who the woman was. It was me.
You.
That was the first impression. You know, that was me.
I could see her clear as day, you know, standing there like this, you know, like.
You were a man in that life, in that world. I see you coming up. You see yourself. You have a different type of, some kind of robe-looking thing.
I was just had a mustache or something, you know, in that life, too, you know.
And we look very human.
Yeah.
It's very human-looking.
Yeah, very curly mustache, you know, like this. I'm just reminded of the guys remind me of the guy from The Wizard of Oz a little bit. You know, the guy does, you know. But me, you know, the one that answers the door at the Emerald City, you know, with his curly mustache, except for he's tall and thin, you know.
It almost looks like this. We can't put these things in words. I wish you could see this better, but, I mean, the air almost seems like it's shimmering with colors.
Oh, yeah.
And this is physical world.
Yeah, I always feel like that.
It's in this universe.
When we start talking about that, like, you know, I started seeing, like, and I've seen this other times, a lot of greenery, you know what I'm saying? A lot of, you know, a lot of the buildings and stuff around a lot of, like, green trees and things. There must be, like, excellent oxygen. I'm thinking that they're enclosed or something, you know what I mean? It must be. I didn't mean to interrupt.
No, it's all right. No, throw in what you feel.
Yeah, there's very excellent oxygen there, you know.
I see it. It's like a shield around, like, the planet. I can see it. I'm being shown a view from space. Of this. You see that? It's like a shield encompassing the whole world.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. It's almost like a bubble.
Bubble.
Yeah.
That's through the space. It's outside of it. It's like huge. It's clear and huge.
It's not glass.
It's not glass. Yeah. It's some kind of energy thing.
Or force or something. Yeah, energy force. Yeah, I see that too.
And there's ships circling, some type of ship circling that fades in and out.
I can hear it in my head when they're going around.
Some of them are sitting still.
Yeah,
floating in the air down there.
You have to wonder what's going on in some of these situations, you know, like I can see them eating, you know, and things like that too, you know, like just little things in life, you know, walking around, you know, looking, and I don't see any stores, but I see them eating, you know what I'm
saying?
Like just eating.
There's no need for money. That's something. No, I see money with the X through.
Yeah, I don't see that.
Exactly. There's no money. No, nothing like that. You create what you want to eat with your thoughts.
Yeah, I can see that aliens are probably really good at that. You know,
thought is king. That's something like we need to write about. That. See, we talked about Jeremy and I. We planned these videos out. We try to plan out, think about ideas beforehand, and we were having struggling today. Now. I got another idea for a video. We need to talk about that. Thought is king, which it is. That's how these ships work, a lot of them. It's not some mechanical thing. It's thought. You interface your thoughts with the operations of these things. And your thoughts can do the control. You sit there and think, move, or this and that, and it moves and does this, that. Your thoughts are control.
It's like, if you want to, like, kind of like you say, rogue. Mm-hmm.
Like, just like in the spirit world.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, but it's actually happening in the physical universe.
Yeah,
it's gone. You do it like that.
But see, we probably can do it.
We can do it.